In this video, something about a VHF very high frequency oscillator. And when we are talking about VHF, you can say it goes from 100 megahertz up to say 300 megahertz, and after that we talk about UHF, ultra high frequencies, etc. And of course with satellite television reception or other satellite applications, we are really in the gigahertz band where we receive radio signals. This is only a very simple oscillator on VHF working between 100 megahertz and 80 megahertz. And in this video I want to tell something about how to make such an oscillator or another VHF circuit. I have to say I don't have so much experience with VHF circuits, so anyway, but I of course know something about good practice, and this is one of the ways that good practice works. We make that circuit, I made that circuit with a so-called Manhattan style electronics. Manhattan style is in fact very simple. The whole copper clad board here works as a kind of mass plate, in general connected to the minus, could of course also be connected to the positive, but anyway, many VHF transistors, etc. are NPN transistors, so that means that you can use the copper clad board here as the minus, and I've done that too here, to the minus, working on 12.2 volts anyway. And the good thing of this Manhattan style is that all the capacitance, the stray capacitance, is more or less fixed. So you have, say, small plates of copper clad board, and they are in the adverse way glued to the massive minus board. So you have here a kind of island here on which you can make your high frequency or VHF frequency circuit. Islands here, and the whole copper clad board here acts as a kind of high frequency shielding. So I've soldered here all the parts of the horizontal and the vertical board together. That's important because no, say, VHF radio signal or whatever must be able to enter the hole, say, grounded or in another way shielded circuit. So no high frequencies can leak through all these, say, gaps, etc., etc. Anyway, here is that VHF oscillator I studied. This radio magazine for radio amateurs of my association Veron Radio Association, and here there are, say, a few interesting things that they tell about oscillators. This is a first schematic of an oscillator, and in fact we see here an amplifier, could be a high frequency amplifier. When you use, for instance, a high frequency transistor, and here is the part that makes the circuit oscillate. This is the Dutch text. Has everything to do with, say, the phase of the output signal that is sent back to the input signal. Anyway, the Hartley oscillator here. And I've used this Hartley oscillator as an inspiration for my circuit that I will show. And here I tested this circuit, it didn't work. Could be, of course, that I made some mistakes, but anyway, the problem in this circuit is, in my opinion, that this is series resonance. So that is another type of resonance compared to the parallel resonance. So I'm absolutely sure that you can get it working. But anyway, that were all the ideas. I also studied circuits with, say, grounded base oscillators, grounded emitter oscillators, but here you see the circuit that I finally made on the basis of that book of my radio society. Veron, Society for Experimental Radio Research. Anyway, this circuit proved to work. That's why I publish it. I've taken the whole circuit completely apart and then built it up in a new way. So in this way, the aim is of this circuit that I want to mount here a high frequency stage. And this will be the oscillator, perhaps there will be a mixer, etc., etc. I'm absolutely not sure how this whole circuit will develop in the future. But anyway, I want to show it and that it works. We're listening now on the, 88 megahertz band up to 108 megahertz band. So a lot of noise. I can't stand that noise in a certain way. Kind of irritating noise, but anyway, we need it to show this circuit anyway. And here I set the bias of that first BF199 transistor has an effect on the frequency. You can hear that here. So when I move the screwdriver into this circuit, it has an effect on the frequency, but that is not a problem. When it is aligned well, there is no noise any longer generated by this piece of metal. That is also something to do with VHF circuits and their properties, etc., etc. So, set the BIOS. And you can hear that the BIOS has an effect on the frequency, but it's much more important here that this coil and this capacitor here sets the frequency in a much better way, because they are the frequency dependent elements. It's quite a problem to stick in the screwdriver. Sorry. And there is somewhere on this high frequency band a position and this is the position. So, this is the position. Where the signal of the VHF oscillator overrules the frequency on 108 megahertz. And I found in the past, yesterday, that you can keep such a frequency completely silent. That means that this oscillator is stable. Of course, when it is not stable, you will hear the radio signal here on 108 megahertz appear or disappear, but this oscillator is able to get out a very stable frequency on the VHF band. And there's even no hand effect here. When it oscillates, this was of course hand effect, but I can bring it back to a more stable frequency. So there is hand effect, but it's limited. And in these circuits, there are always a kind of compartments between, say, the first stage and the second stage. That is everything to do with the whole circuit on VHF. Everything, every stray capacitance, stray inductance has an influence, and that must be limited as much as possible by, say, compartments for the VHF oscillator and the IF amplifier and the mixer, etc. So in this way, but of course when I move this plate to the coil, the frequency will change. So anyway, only some good practice in this video. And say I'm more or less absolutely sure that this oscillator is usable 4VHF experiments between, say, 80 megahertz and 120 megahertz, and perhaps even higher. Of course, in that case, the coil has to have less windings. Now, it is 6 turns here. But on, say, higher frequencies, you can shortcut that coil with a small wire here between the first and the second winding, and that means that the coil and the parallel capacitor here, that red one, can be tuned to a higher frequency. On VHF, say 130 megahertz or perhaps 150, I don't know. It's experimental.